We used to run track and field together in high school. He was just as tall back then, too. He was always faster than me. I wish we kept running together once we got into college. I tried to. Everyone changes in college. Well, he was always stubborn. But we never drank. Or went to parties before this. I was already worn down. Even before he started pushing me away. And eventually, it got difficult to care. But I knew I still wanted to. I had to remind myself that this wasn't my fault. I knew I was still a good person.
Always be exothermic though?
Chemical decomposition always requires an activation energy, but if it's spontaneous, it'll be exothermic. It's all in the notes I sent you last night.
So I even got the multiple choice wrong. Jet Eds can suck my dick. If I wasn't in this section with you, man, I'd be fucked.
What's going on? You see something?
Nah, man. It's just the shoes. For every pair up there, people have been a shit ton of places. Tons of stories you'll never know about. And everyone up there bought a new pair of shoes and just kind of moved on. Existential, if you think about it.
Sure.
You should throw yours up there. They're all beat up.
Aren't you only supposed to do that during graduation?
Give you a reason to replace them. I'm gonna have some people over tonight. Hope that's cool.
Yeah, that's fine. Just don't go too crazy, I guess.
I'm flying high, but I've got a feeling I'm falling. Falling for nobody else but you. You caught my eye, and I've got a feeling I'm falling. Show me the ring and I'll jump right through. I used to travel single, oh, we chance to mingle, oh, now I'm a tingle over you. Hey, Mr. Paulson, stand by.
Hey, I'm sorry about last weekend, man. I really appreciate you looking out for me.
Oh, yeah, sure thing.
I really appreciate you.
Thanks?
No, like, I really fucking appreciate you, man.
Yeah, I hear you, dude.
Ben, come on, you designated hydrated son of a bitch, we're going out.
Wilder, where are we going?
I need to pick up some stuff from a guy in town.
So we're going into the middle of town at night while you're drunk so you get high with some guy?
Hey! What? You're about to walk under the statue. They say if you walk under the statue, you won't graduate.
Excuse me.
Wow, slow down, come on!
Fucking...
I'm worried. Should we follow him? Ben, how are you not wearing boots?
No, I like these shoes.
Is that a hole? Are you gonna be able to follow Wilder in the snow? Man, these are fucked. Why do you still have them?
I don't know. Wilder got them for me for my birthday last year. I doubt he even remembers. And they're comfortable too, I guess.
Wilder! Stop! Wilder!
Yeah?
Slow down!
I don't want to.
You can't always get what you want, can you?
Didn't know you were a Stones fan.
You can't do that.
What can't I do exactly?
We're just worried is all.
No, what can't I do exactly?
You can't run into the middle of the city at 2 a.m. drunk to get high and then walk back alone. It makes me worried.
You're not worried. You're afraid.
What's the fucking difference?
You don't care about me. You're afraid of the consequences. You're afraid that if you don't butt in, I'm your fault.
Well, don't worry. I'm well aware that most everything is your fault.
Yeah.
And when something bad happens, that's on you, not me.
All right.
But remember, when you're lying on your back, choking on your own vomit, you can't come crawling back to me.
You're the one following me right now.
Do you want me to go?
Yeah.
Fine. I guess you can always get what you want.
Wilder okay?
Just peachy.
So he is okay?
Yeah.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
I'm worried about him.
Guys, you should just head back. It's getting late. Nothing good happens after 2 a.m., you know.
Yeah. Come on, let's go.
Here, I'll text you when he gets home, okay?
All right. Thanks.
When night is creeping and I should be sleeping in bed. If you are peeping, you'll find that I'm weeping in bed. My loving daddy left his baby again. Said he'd come back, but he forgot to say when. Night after night, I'm crying. Daddy, won't you please come home? Daddy, won't you please come home? I'm so lonesome.
The whole time, I wondered which part of him was lying. The projecting of his own apathy was the thing that made me the most angry. But it did make me realize something important. I care about him, but he's not my responsibility. He's his own person. I shouldn't feel guilty.
Talk. You know, I felt content listening to your advice. You know, for a second it felt nice.
So what's stopping you?
Sarah wanted me to talk with you. She's worried.
Just stop.
Wilder, she wants to help.
Deal with me on your own wasn't enough. You have to be some reluctant white knight. Shit, man. What a hero. How selfish.
Oh my god, will you get out of your head for one goddamn second?
And there it is, the condescension. I don't want any part of your ivory tower pity party bullshit.
Well, what do you want?
To not be lied to. You used to like me. Now you can't stand me. And why should you? I'm worthless. I'm an anchor. The only thing that hurts more than knowing that you're better off without me is seeing you lie through your fucking teeth. You don't care about me anymore.
Wilder, I do care about you.
I can see it in your eyes. It's always there, looking down on me. Let go. Stop lying.
I'm done. I'm done with your narrative you're always spitting.
I catch you, and I'm the bad guy. I'm done. I'm sick of your immaturity, your manipulation. Your phony philosophizing, you fucking vomit everywhere all the fucking time. I take care of you like you're my fucking child. You're a burden. And I just wish you were gone.
You can't help someone who doesn't want to be helped. Sometimes you have to be able to let go.
Are you all right, Ben?
Yeah.
Would you like to continue sharing?
No. I think I'm done.
Well, thank you for sharing your story with us. It is important to realize that we are not guilty and should not feel any blame for the disease that is affecting our loved ones. Ben's story serves as a reminder of the importance of the three C's. I did not cause it, I cannot control it, and I cannot cure it. A fourth C that is sometimes mentioned is that I do not have to contribute to it. Sometimes we contribute to it by doing for our loved ones what they can do for themselves, or cushioning them from the consequences of their bad decisions. You don't have this power or responsibility over anyone else. And prioritizing your well-being is not a selfish thing to do. We can be loving and supportive, but if we expend all of our energy constantly rescuing and rescuing, it will only contribute to the problem and invite more chaos. In order to begin the long process of healing, we have to let go of this feeling of guilt and work on our ability to focus on and take care of ourselves. Yeah. All right, looks like I've run a few minutes over. Thank you, everyone. Just so everyone knows, next week's meeting is temporarily moved to room 218. Also, let me know if you want to be added to the email list. We send out updates about all the meetings and different events that are coming up. See you next week.